Well, I think there are better note-taking apps on the App Store. Totes and Notes does have some features that may be very attractive to school kids. I'll show you what I mean. So if we click on the plus to add a new note, we can then click on the note and we get the choice of having different folder covers. So if we click on the folders, we can actually choose a theme for our folder. So students may like this. They can stick with something quite plain, or they can go with something a bit more interesting. Some mazes on the covers or various patterns, or there's some others down the bottom. Funnily enough, I'm not sure why it's advertising a Honda Civic car, but we'll choose this cover. So it's given us an interesting cover. The other thing students can do to make their folders look a little different is add a range of predetermined stickers. So there's a fair selection of stickers there that they can put onto their folder. So let's choose Top Secret, and then we can move the sticker around. Okay, so if we set up a folder, it's just like students would set up folders for their different subjects. So what we need to do is label this folder. So if you click on the little tab there, it actually lets you type in a label for the folder. So let's say this is going to be their folder for English. So we've labeled that folder as English. If we open up the folder, you can begin drawing and taking notes. So just on the right hand side there, you can see it says open folder. So we can click on that and it'll open up the note set for us. What we can now do, click on the note taking page, it will then allow us to add a note if we click on plus. So it gives us a note taking page. There's a few ways we can add notes to that page. If we just tap on customise, we can do a few different things. We can use a pen tool in blue or black, and you can actually write with a pen. So that's fairly straightforward. There is also a marker, so you can use a black marker. They do actually give you a pencil option as well. So say you were trying to draw a graph, you could use a pencil option as well. The eraser with an adjustable size quite simply lets you erase things that have been included. And the type button allows you to type in some text on the sheet. So if you double click on a section, it will allow us to type. And if you wanted to change the font, click on type and you can choose one of the other font types if you like, and it will change the font. So that essentially sets up our folder. They're some of the basic features. The other possible features, you can choose different paper styles. So there's lined, graph paper, or blank. So we can change that. And there's also a good tool in here called your widgets tool. It gives you a calculator, a simple calculator, so you can just do a few calculations and then add that to your notes. And it also gives you some conversion tools, a temperature conversion, Celsius to Fahrenheit. You can also do Kelvins if you're doing science. You can do weight conversions, kilograms to pounds, ounces, etc. Some speed conversions, miles per hour to kilometers per hour, and there is some basic length conversions as well, yards, inches, miles, kilometers. So if we click back to our note set, what you can then do, if we made that first note, if we close that, it shows us in our folder, our English folder, that our first note was made on the 6th of March at 12:13 p.m. Now I'd like to make another note, so in maybe the next class, you go and make a few more notes, and once again, you can do the same thing all over again. So let's click customise, double click on the page, and we can add some more notes. Okay, and all the other features are the same. Students can add stickers right throughout the presentation. So this is where the feature might just, students might be a bit more engaged with some of these additional features. Once we finish that, click close. Now we've got our second note in there. If you want to view your notes again, you just tap on them and it brings up that particular note page. So it's pretty good. And then if you want to go back to your bookshelf, if we click back to the shelf, It shows us all of your folders that you have, and at the moment I've just got the one. So students could set up one folder for each subject. So if you click on the minus, you can actually send folders to the trash if you want to delete them, but we don't want to do that, so click on it again. You can also customize the front of the folder with the pen and pencil drawing tools, as well as the stickers we've already included, and changing the folder pattern. The last thing to look at is how you actually remove notes if you no longer want them. So inside the folder, if you just click on a note, you'll see down in the left-hand corner there is a trash symbol. So you click on that and it removes your notes. You can search your notes, so if you've given them specific headings or words in the notes, you can search those. If you go into one of your folders, it's quite easy to share your notes. So what you need to do, open a particular note, and then if you click on share, it will allow you to send a PDF of the notes that turns up in the email screen there. So it's quite easy. Say a student missed out on a class, one of their friends who's taken their notes could quite easily share them by simply emailing them through. The other thing to look at is, if we go back to our shelf, I've got two folders on there now. I've got an English and a physics folder. There is a feature in this app that'll do an in-app backup. So if you click on the clock with the arrow symbol, it takes you to a library. If you click plus to save the library, it actually brings up a set of folders, but if you click on the folders, it saves the two documents that you've already made, physics and English. So this is essentially a backup copy that's separate from your bookshelf. So I'll show you what I mean. If we go back to our shelf, let's now click on the minus. Let's remove these two documents. Okay, so now we no longer have our folders on our bookshelf. But what we can do, if we later realize that we probably wanted to keep one of those, we can click back to the library, we can click on the notes, and it asks us if we want to restore the physics or the English or both sets of folders. So if we restore the physics folder, it goes back to your bookshelf. And if we look back at our bookshelf now, there's the physics folder that I made, and it still has the notes in that I've added. So that's quite a good feature. Students can keep their primary bookshelf nice and neat and tidy with current work, but before they delete folders, they can add a copy to their library to save if they ever need to refer back to it.